There's the P&P Mountain, and straight up above, right about in there, is where Stan's at. So, Stan's about 4,500 feet over P Mountain now, so I'm gonna zoom up. It's right about in there. I'm gonna try to zoom, but he's up in this area somewhere. Golf ball and Stan right there. He's coming in on downwind. There's Andy stirring up some dust down. For the record books, boy, flew from noon all the way to what time is it? Ground down. What time? What time you got?
I have 7:26.
So about a, I would say he flew about 7.5 hours. Dan, you flew for about 7 hours, you know that? It's a little after 7 o'clock, and I think you took off before noon.
Oh, wow.
So,
7 hours.
Might not have been the longest distance in a straight line, but I guarantee you, you flew a lot of miles today.
Oh, yeah. You see how the thing dropped? That gradient?
Yeah, it came through the gradient, but it's still a very nice landing. Yeah.
That's
yeah. Still look good though. So what was Stan? What was your highest altitude? Was that 14,000 something? 14.5, I think you said, or 14.1?
I heard you go through 14.1.
14, yeah. But I have to hit the menu button.
Okay.
Hold it down. And does it have a flight memory stick? Okay. Oh wait, it hasn't finished recording yet. I don't want to disturb it.
Okay.
I have to let it, I gotta take it out of this menu, I gotta turn it off. Then it'll generate a signature. Now it should say flight analysis. 14114. 14,114.
And does it give us any kind of mileage?
That's the max speed. And I don't think so. I think the websites are going to do that.
Yeah.
They're going to give me...
Does it give you a time of flight?
7 hours, 16 minutes.
Yeah.
7 hours, 16 minutes.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had